And we have a go for auto sequence start.
In the next few moments, liquid oxygen and liquid hydrogen at minus 253 degrees Celsius will be pumped at 1,035 gallons per second, then ignited, creating a force of 37 million horsepower, sending the temperature in the combustion chamber to over 3,000 degrees Celsius.
T-minus 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Booster ignition and liftoff of Discovery.
Where do you find the know-how to make that work?
Opening new gateways for international science.
Here, at the Kennedy Space Center Cryogenics Test Laboratory.
Cryogenics is all about energy. Space exploration or space launch, those are some very energy-intensive endeavors. But cryogenics touches on more than just space. It touches on nearly all aspects of modern life.
Cryogenics keeps our food fresh, keeps us healthy, helps power our businesses and our home, now and in the future. It's about energy management and economics. At the vanguard of all this is NASA's Cryogenics Test Lab.
And we have two main ways of operating. One is problem solving, short-term, real problems in industry and with the NASA missions. And the second approach is our main mission is long-term research and development.
It's an interdisciplinary total system approach involving testing insulation materials under extreme temperatures and pressures, combined with problem solving using material science and engineering. Their work has led to many new developments in cryogenics.
Our layered composite insulation is a revolutionary insulation because it works not only at high vacuum very well, but it also is the world's best at soft vacuum, opening up a range of possibilities from liquid hydrogen cars to high-temperature superconducting cables.
Polyimide foams for construction and transportation, pourable aerogels for liquid gas carriers and superconducting cables.
We partnered with 3M to install this insulation system.
These and many other innovative insulations are the products of thousands of tests on hundreds of materials in the process of compiling a one-of-a-kind database of thermal conductivity measurements.
Well, we can test all different materials, bulk fill, powder types that you pour in, clamshell molded shapes, panels. This is a copper sleeve. It's part of the Cryostat 100 system. It's the cold mass portion.
Cryostat 100 can measure a wide range of temperature differences for cylindrical insulations. It's one of five unique custom-designed cryostats able to test material specimens as small as 75 millimeters in diameter to storage tanks and pipelines over 20 meters long at a variety of temperatures and pressures in actual use conditions.
We have some unique capabilities and expertise, so we're looking to partner with others and extend applications into transportation and power industries and practical problems in industry. There's so much that can be done with energy efficiency.
Hello, I'm Jim Nichols, Licensing Manager here at the Kennedy Space Center. For more information on utilizing our cryogenics laboratory, or licensing one of our many available technologies, please give us a call,